Welcome to Jackal Digital. I'm Simon, and today we'll be taking a look how to make an image particle animation. And depending on how it's done, it can also be used as a video transition. Now let's jump into DaVinci Resolve and see this voodoo in action. We have two ways to go about this, a fusion composition or an image. The only difference between the two is at the end if you want to export the video with a transparent background. In that case, choose the fusion composition. To make a fusion composition, you can right-click in the media pool and select new fusion composition. You will get a file in here and just drag it on the timeline. Or you can type in the search fusion and you can also just drag it. If you went with an image, you can put it directly from your PC. You just drag it in, or you can drag it into the pool and then drag it on the timeline. And whichever way you chose, just select the file that you have on the timeline and click on the Fusion tab. Now, depending on how you did the first step, if you went with the Fusion composition, you will just have the media out. But if you went with the image, you will also have a media in. So in my case, I'll choose the media in, which is the logo. If you don't have it in the media pool, you can also go into your PC files where you have them, and then drag it onto the fusion composition. So now we have a media in, which is the image, and a media out. I always start by adding a background node. I do this when I want to have the final output as a full screen, which means that it's basically what you see is what you get. And we need to add a merge node, which I've added using control space to get the select tool, and I typed merge and added it. Now, to make the basic particle image animation, we need two nodes. One you can find in here, which is the particle render, and the one we want, because it's for the image, you can either use control space to get the select tool, or right click, go under add tool, particles, and particle image emitter. The only thing that we absolutely need to adjust is the output mode, which is 2D. What you may want to watch out for, if the render is of lower size than what your output is, make sure it's the same as your output so you don't have any issues. And if we want to see the actual particles, we need to connect these three nodes together. And now let's take a look at the particle image emitter. And as you might have noticed, there is a little P at the front. This means that it's a particle. And what the particle image emitter does is it emits particles based on the input, and in this case it's an image. Now select the particle image emitter and open the inspector if you haven't already. Now the image emitter node has quite a few of attributes and settings, as you can see, that we can change, but we only need to change a couple of them. The settings that we want to change are the densities. If you max this out, you see how many particles you get. Currently, the max value is set at 2, but you can change this. But if you change the values, you will need more processing power to compile this. But for now, I will keep this setting at 1. Then we can change the lifespan. As you can see, we have 150 frames, and this is currently at 100 frames. You can change this if you want, but it is not required. And then the main settings that we'll want to change are under the velocity, which is speed, how fast the particles will move. As you see now, the image is moving from left to right, and this is the default direction the particles move. And you can also use some velocity difference, so not every particle is moving the same. And the main property that we want to change is the angle Z, which needs to be minus 90, if we want the particles to move out towards us. And the other main thing that we need to change is the style. We will change it to a blob. And now that it's a blob, we can also change the size of the blob. So we can increase it so we have the full image. We can also add a little bit of variance to the size. And then if this is size 0, we can also increase what the size of the blobs will be with increased amount of time that they're alive. As you can see, size over life, and we specified that 100 frames is the lifespan. So the longer they're on the screen, the bigger they will get. But the issue then is if they get off the screen. And the other important setting is under the render node and controls and enable kill particles that leave the view. Because anything that's out of the view, it doesn't need to be rendered, so it will speed things up. The animation is now pretty much done, since it is a basic one. So currently it looks something like this. And as I said, it starts immediately. And what I showed you in the beginning was just my image. And then the particles started going out of it. And to do that, we need two more nodes. One is speed, time speed. This node basically just says what the delay should be in frames. So in this case, 30 frames would be 1 second. So I will delay this by 1 second. And the time speed node should get the input after the render is done. Like so. But if I display this now, nothing will be at the start and it will come after 1 second. So how do we add that image in front? You could try with the merge node, but that won't work, as you will see, because the background is always present, and if we flip it around, it's still not the result that we want. So how can we fix this? We will add another kind of node. Go here and type dissolve. And what dissolve will do for us is simply switch between the two inputs. And it looks like this. First was this image without the effect. And after 1 second, it's the image with the effect. And once the effect is done, that's it. Just how you want it. And you don't have to change any setting in the dissolve node. Then you connect the dissolve to this merge node. And you can set the merge to have the blend mode so it's not visible at the start. Maybe 0 at the start, and at 20 frames it comes in. I'll now display the media out. And now you see there is quite a big jump, right? So how can we fix this now? We go back into the render node, and under, what is this? Under scenes, we have translation. And in my case, because I've already done this example, it's 1.4. You can view the translation z-axis as a scale, but in the opposite way. So when we increase this, the image goes down. So it's almost the same, but it doesn't matter because the change will be fast enough that this is not visible. And because the particles are going out towards us anyway, it doesn't make any sense to adjust this any further. So I'll just render this out now, so you can see the final result. One thing that you will notice now is that because I only have a lifespan of 100 frames and the delay is 30 frames, I still have particles on the screen, and one frame after 130, they will just disappear, which is not very cool. So how you can fix that is to go into the particle emitter and just increase the velocity. So in my case, maybe I'll do something like this. Basically, you just want to increase the speed so the particles go out of the screen before they disappear abruptly. This is the result that I used with an image. I dragged the image in and then made the fusion composition out of it. Now, because I couldn't export it as a video, I've copied everything that is inside the fusion composition, all of the nodes except for the input and the media out. I made a new fusion composition, went inside and just pasted it, and dragged the image down and connected it to these two points. And as you can see, you can use this kind of video effect even as a transition. And if you want to know how to make a video with a transparent background, watch the video on how to make call to action animations. And that concludes this video. If you found it helpful, like and subscribe. Hit the bell icon so you don't miss my next video. I'm Simon. Thank you for watching. Until next time, Jackals, keep it digital.